Rajni, first and foremost, I would like to respond to what Babul Supriyo ji said. He said Hinduism is civilization. And let me remind you, world over, humanity is civilization. Any religion does not matter. This country is not about Hinduism. This country is not about fanatism. This country is not about any ism what you talk about. This country is about diversity. This country is about a Muslim being married to a Hindu being married to a Christian, living in harmony. A secular country which, unfortunately, the ruling government wanted to take away the word secular. When you talk about Hindu divide, it's not the Karnataka government saying that this one government, BJP, is talking about one nation, one religion. I think that's the motto of the BJP, who have been propagating that. Secondly, we have seen BJP government in the past. We have seen a great leader and a wonderful statesman such as Atal Bihari Vajpayee ji leading the country. And we still say as a Congress, though we were in opposition even then, we still consider him as one of the best leaders we have had in our country. We didn't have this problem then. We didn't have Gaumutra. We didn't have Gaurakshak. We didn't have one religion, one nation. We didn't have this divide of Hindu, Muslim, Sikh, Isai. We didn't have this divide then. We worked in harmony because there was one man who believed that everyone is equal. The religion, what we talk about, should be remained in the four walls of our homes. The minute you walk out of the door, the minute you are out there and on the public platform or a forum on the streets, this country is equal to every human who walks on that road. That is what the greatness was.
There have been riots in this country that have taken place in the past, including Karnataka. You seem to be suggesting as if India changed in May 2014. Till then,
India
everything
has
was
changed.
Fine.
We are seeing the kind of problems we have seen. We have never seen it in the past. The kind of problems we're seeing.
Khushbu was not in Congress when the Congress party called Atal Bihari Vajpayee a fascist.
Amit Shah calling even Mahatma Gandhi as a Chatur Baniya. So we are not going to go into that debate, Malavika. But I am trying to tell you, today, everywhere BJP has a problem. No, let me finish, please. I did not interrupt when all of you were speaking. When a BJP guy finds out that Khushbu Sundar is actually a Nakhat Khan, they have a problem. The minute they realize that I'm an atheist and I'm married to a Hindu, then they troll and they say that I turned into an atheist because I had a fear that my Hindu husband and his family might force me to turn into a Hinduism and change. The minute they realize that there's a kind of a religious function in my house or a puja in my house or I accompany my husband to a temple, then they have an issue with me that how can an atheist, that to a Muslim, can go to a temple. I say I have a duty. I'm an atheist and that is by choice. But as a woman of the family, as a caretaker of the family, as a wife, as a daughter-in-law, as a daughter, I think it is my duty to stand by my family and my husband in all the religious aspects. It's not that I have turned an atheist, you know, like by birth. No. It was by choice in 2004 when there were 100 kids, young kids who were killed in Kumbakonam fire. And all the adults were, they just went, but there were 100 kids who were charred beyond recognition. And that's when I said, there's no karma, there's no God, because if there was one God or one Allah or one Jesus Christ or any God for that matter, at least one child would have been saved. But not a single child was saved and there were 100 kids. Imagine the plight of the family. Imagine the, and they were all young tots, five-year-old kids. What is their karma? And that is when I decided to turn an atheist. But I'm the same person who have been to Tirupati, woke up at 1:30 in the morning, done Anga Pradarsanam. I have been a believer, but it is by choice. But today the BJP wants to divide. BJP wants to bring in religion in every possible matter. My family, I'm married to a Hindu. My brother is married to a Christian. The other brother is married to another Christian. My other brother is married to a Muslim. We live in harmony. What is anybody's problem? Whether I beef, I eat pork, or I do anything within my house, on my plate. What I wear a bindi, I don't wear a bindi. What is BJP's problem? I have lived in this country. I was born in this country, and I say I'm a proud Indian. My patriotism, it runs in my blood. But I want to ask BJP, and I don't say as a Congress person. And I say this as a citizen of this country. What is your problem? What we do within our house or what we do with our lives? Whether I love, I marry, I die, I commit suicide, I do whatever I want. It is my choice.
Okay.
BJP has no rights to interfere in my life. Then that's it. And this comes as an individual, as a Congress person. Yes, we will fight this out. It is a fight because we, as Congress, we have always believed in secularism. We have always believed in harmony. We have been wrong in times. We have gone wrong. And I'm not saying that no, we have been absolutely saint. We have made mistakes, but we have learned from our mistakes. And we want to set that right. And we will set it right in Karnataka this election.
Okay, that's a very, very strong and emotional piece. Where you speech...